Tonight, tonight, tonight. Whoa, okay, that's good. Cheers. Peeps up and down the city, don't try to come for me. What do I always say? Read the title before you click. Read the title before you click. Before we keep going, I just need to say, if you are not of age, this is not for you. If you want to hang out, get you some Kool-Aid. I'm doing just a little basic today. Yellowtail, sponsor me. I'm your girl. If you want to get you a little cocktail, pause the video, get you a little cocktail, a little glass of wine, what if we do a little Don Julio, whatever you like to do, let's just do it. Let's just drag the girls, so, you know what I'm saying? So let's just get right into it. I bought some new foundation today, a little drugstore foundation. There we go. It's about to get real busted the house down boots.
I also picked up some new little sponges.
So let's see. Oh no, I think it's too light. Okay. In person, it's not this light. Why does it look like it's on camera? Oh, I brought the wrong color. Yesterday I was looking into something. I don't even know how I fell down some rabbit hole. This is kind of old tea, but it's new to me. So like y'all know the girl, the rapper, Azalea Banks. She's a rapper, but she's like known for everything but rapping. Like she's always like in some tea and some drama. Well, like how come no one told me that like a couple months ago, she made a video, I guess like an Instagram video or something. She dug up the cat and made a video of her digging up the cat and boiling it and cooking it. And like, it was like, it's one thing to do it, but then like you're filming it and upload like this shit. I mean, like I knew she was like a troll and like problematic and like all this other kind of stuff, but like somebody like for real, like go check up on that girl. Like, I don't know. And I was like, why would she? But then I saw some people saying like she does, I don't know, supposedly, allegedly, look, this is me talking my trash, dabbles in some kind of witchcraft or something. I don't really keep tabs on this Azalea Banks chick, but I don't know. Somebody please send help to that girl. Okay, so there's that. I saw where Quavo and Sweetie broke up. Like, oh my gosh. I mean, look, a lot of people are like, oh, I seen it coming. Like, you know, they're young. Like, he's this major successful rapper. Supposedly, allegedly, he cheated on her. I'm not gonna call the man a cheater. I'm not gonna say that he didn't. I don't know those people. But apparently, that was a huge contributing factor as to why they broke up. So yeah, so if you don't know, Quavo's from the Migos, the rap group, and then Sweetie, she is a female rapper too. Both very successful, they've been dating for a while. I mean, it was kind of sad. A lot of people had jokes and stuff saying, cause you know, Quavo's in the same, is in Migos with Offset, who is Cardi B's husband. And like a lot of people had jokes like, oh, Offset telling Quavo how to get back Sweetie. And there's a lot of jokes and stuff floating around. But you know, that's what people do. You make memes and stuff. You had A-Rod and J-Lo. One day the wedding is off. The next day is, well, we're just working through some things. I mean, when you're a celebrity, like a part of it is sharing some of your personal life, and it's up to you to decide how much you want to share with the public. People are kind of over the breakups and in getting together, because a lot of people feel like, okay, is this a stunt? Like, are you coming out with new music? Like, what's going on? Especially when it's a situation where people are breaking up and then getting back together. It's like, okay, is it stunts? Is it the con artistry? You know, is it, you know, how much of it is really real? Are these people even really dating? Are they just saying they're breaking up because somebody's about to come out with a new album? Like, it's very that. The thing of it is that you don't know. Some of it's real, some of it's not. It's entertainment. I mean, you can't take anything too seriously. No, this is not me trying to do my makeup well. I'm just trying to get it done for this little video so I can. But yeah, back to A-Rod and J-Lo. I was just saying, you know, a couple weeks before, I don't know when I'm putting this video up, so this might be really old tea by the time I put this video up, I don't know. But a few weeks before A-Rod and J-Lo broke up, I was just saying,
like, well, you know what, if anybody's gonna make it, it's gonna be them. And I said that because
A-Rod kind of knows about that life, but he's not still in that life. And so he can understand who she is. She's J-Lo, you know what I'm saying? But they're not competing for the spotlight, but he's not so out of like that scene that he doesn't get what all that lifestyle entails and what it really means to be J-Lo. You know, y'all get what I'm saying? Spray that. I just thought that they were gonna do it, you know? Cause I kinda thought her and Mark Anthony could have made it happen, but what I feel like what happened was J-Lo and Mark were both kind of at the same kind of level in their career, and it's kind of like, okay, so who's gonna settle down? Who's gonna settle down and take a back seat? It's hard to be at that same type of level. And this is just, I have no facts to back this up. This is just me speculating my conspiracy theory, allegedly. Take a grain of salt with what I'm saying. But I feel like, you know, you have your kids. Some people feel like, well, are you gonna settle down? And she's like, well, why should I? Just cause I'm a woman, I'm supposed to be. You know, it's kind of like, how do you live that kind of lifestyle? You're never really seeing your spouse. You're on opposite sides of the world. You know, it gets lonely. And I just think that they were both. You kind of need a spouse with somebody that can travel with you. Y'all get what I'm saying? I think it could have worked, but it was just, they were both at their prime, and it was just very hard. And I'm sure other reasons why they couldn't work out, blah 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 blah. But I thought that A-Rod and they still might. I don't know that they won't. I'm not saying that they won't. I'm just saying we'll. And I'm not saying that this is Mark or A-Rod, but some men cannot deal with the woman being the breadwinner. Some men can't deal with the woman being the more famous one. Or, you know, a lot of people say, well, it must be a reason why J-Lo can't keep a man, Ariana can't keep a man, Taylor Swift can't keep a man. It must be something wrong with them. What are they doing? They can't this and that or whatever. I call it the Miley Lim syndrome. Not so much Lim, but his family wanted Miley to sit down and be this little country club girl and have tea and crumpets on, you know, very much Chanel and brunch on Sunday mornings. And she is just not that girl. She's not that girl. You know, he wanted her to sit down and be this cute little housewife. And Miley's like, please. You know what I mean? And it's not like she put on this facade like she was gonna sit down. Like, I'm Miley Cyrus. I'm Ariana Grande. And that's a lot. Some men just want a old-fashioned traditional woman, and there's nothing wrong with that. It takes a certain kind of man to be able to be the man of Miley Cyrus, Taylor Swift. It's not just music industries. Anybody. It could be a politician, it could be a surgeon, it could be anybody. That's why, you know, a lot of times you get surgeons that marry surgeons, because that's the kind of really the only person that can really understand that type of lifestyle, the long hours, the traveling. If you have a job that keeps you away from home a lot, that keeps you on the go-go, you know, they realize that these people are like, I'm Ariana Grande, I'm not gonna sit down. I'm at the height of my career. What do you want me to do? You heard it here? You know? Deshaun Watson. All my man's trying to leave the Texans. If you don't know Deshaun Watson, if you don't keep up with NFL, Deshaun Watson, NFL player, plays for the Texans. Long story, but he's trying to leave, and now all of a sudden these allegations about that he done this stuff to these women. I'm not saying that he didn't. I'm not one to victim shame. All I'm saying is the timing of it is pretty off. It's the connections between the lawyer and the coach. It's the connections. Look into it. It's just the timing and the conflict of interest. It just seems like somebody got upset that Deshaun said that he wants to leave. And now they're trying to tarnish him. and successfully so. Because with allegations like this, it really does not matter whether a person is guilty or not, because forever, from here on out, whenever you Google this person's name, whether they're proven guilty or not, that's always going to be affiliated with their name, the accusation. That's all I'm going to say about that. So have y'all heard about the bad baby Dr. Phil situation that's been going on? Okay, so Bad Baby is Danielle Bergoli, the little girl who was on Dr. Phil years ago when she was like 13 or 11, something like that. Catch me outside, how about that? That girl. So what has come to light is these teen help, these facilities that these parents are sending their kids to in hopes of their kids getting help. In particular, this one that Dr. Phil sends these teenagers to, I mean, it's all kind of crazy that they're just abusing the kids and they're doing the most. They're not really helping these kids. If anything, they're just causing more trauma. And what you have with these places like this, there's no cameras. The kids can't talk to their parents. They can't do anything. And the kids are just out there being abused and neglected and, I mean, just everything under the sun. And so Danielle has made just a tell-all video. First she went on Instagram and rant all that. Then she has come out with an official video calling out Dr. Phil and saying, you need to apologize by April 5th or I'm gonna handle things my own way. So go watch the video and listen to what she says. I mean, this is some very interesting, I ain't gonna call it tea because it's deeper than tea. Another thing that I saw that was interesting, not to jump ship, which we've been jumping ship this whole time, right? You know, Lil Mama. Y'all remember Lil Mama? You know, Bow Wow with a wig. No, I'm just playing. So Lil Mama did something. So Lil Mama, she's a rapper. I don't think she's really active in the music scene right now, but she's the girl to say,
my lip gloss is cool, my lip gloss be popping.
So anyway, so apparently she's supposed to be starting a movement where, I don't know the exact whatever. She's trying to start something where it's for heterosexual rights because she feels like straight people are being bullied by the LGBTQ+ community. If that's what you believe, that's what you believe. But I'm thinking, girl, the only people that are paying your bills, you better cross them, because don't, for a woman, most people don't even know who you are. Nobody's listening to you. And look, bullies come in all shape, forms, and sizes, and come from all different backgrounds. I'm just saying, it ain't happening like that. We need a movement. Like, come on now. You doing a lot, sweetie. Did y'all see the backlash on the Justin Bieber album? Okay, so apparently, so Justin Bieber just came out with a new album. Like I said, I don't know when I'm uploading this video, but there's very mixed emotions with that because he had some snippets of like Martin Luther King's speeches and that kind of thing. His album is called Justice, and some people are like, why is this white man profiting off of Martin Luther King and the civil rights and all this other stuff? And like, then you have Martin Luther King's daughter and like Martin Luther King organization saying thank you, Justin Bieber, for like raising awareness. Because the day before Justin Bieber came out with his album, he was like, hey guys, support these organizations and these charities. But some people were like, why are you using snippets of his speeches from a time that was very crucial in history, things that still haven't changed today, and your album is love songs. It was very divided, but I mean, he's still making his coin. It hasn't slowed down the streams or the sales. I don't know. So what do you think about that? I see both sides of it. I think that it's good because it's probably introducing Martin Luther King and that whole moment to a younger generation who maybe is just learning about it, or maybe didn't know much about it, and they're like, oh, who is this talking, or what is this? Let me go look for it, and maybe they'll learn something. Maybe you got to be a little open-minded. I mean, everybody wants to be offended and upset and sensitive, but...